As the party slinks back through the dark alleyways of Isis back to the Merchant's Hotel from a long night's very successful mission. They've successfully devised a plan to disable all of Isis' air defenses temporarily by hacking the Starport Authority's administrative panel, which they gained access to through clandestine means. And have successfully bought themselves 48 hours to take Isis. It's been a long day and a long night after that. Are you coming back up the fire escape or through the front?
I'd say I think
fire escape would be the best way.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, what was that?
Fire escape.
Okay. Real quick, whoever's got the highest intelligence, give me a raw intelligence check to see if you remember which room it was, which window you climbed out of.
It's probably you.
Yeah, I don't have the highest one.
Well, somebody better. I think that'd be you, James.
I, like, walk up and I see like six and I'm like, sir. Please tell me you remember which window we climbed out of.
I would like to roll intel. Because I believe I have highest intel.
Let's do it.
Okay, am I adding my plus two to my intel with my roll?
Yep, add your modifier.
That's cocked.
I got a 4.
Oof.
So, why are you making that?
There's.
Up? I can try and remember. Wait. You want me to try and roll to see if I can remember?
Go for it.
Oh yeah, mine's dog shit too. That would be a. That would also be a 6. Sorry, 7. That'd be a 7.
Do you want me to roll?
And there's 6 windows here, and nobody's remembering.
I'm gonna, like, walk up to
you,
Josmo, and I'm gonna just, like, kind of tap you and be like, give me your comm. It's a bit early, but I did give Garavik mine, so we should be able to get in contact with him.
I pass you the comm link.
Okay, and I will try to hail Garavik. Come in, Garavik. Are you there?
It takes a moment, and then you hear a... Silas! Silas, is everything okay?
Yeah, fine, actually. We just don't remember which window is yours. Could you open it and... usher us in, please.
I'll be there in just a moment.
Thank you.
It takes a few seconds, and then one of the windows pops open.
That was a close one.
He sticks his head out and waves.
All right, I'm going to climb up.
There he is.
I climb in as well.
I believe we all follow in suit.
Oh, yeah.
How'd your secret mission go?
All the anti-aircraft and...
He doesn't need to know the specifics, sir. Very well.
Yes. Everything shut down for 48 hours.
What did I just say?
I told him.
For 48 hours? You mean you're bringing the Republic Army here now? I gotta get out of ISIS.
It's understandable, Garavik. I do appreciate everything that you've done, and I can. Hopefully, we can count on you as an ally in the future.
I want to grab 15 credits, and I want to hand them to Garavik.
I gave him plenty already.
A little extra.
Y'all are so generous for Jedi. I mean, not to say anything wrong of the Jedi. I mean, I just thank you, sir.
They're just things, Garavik. Things may be replaced. Unlike your life, if you don't get out of here as soon as possible.
Oh, rest assured, Master Jedi, I sure will. And he, with that, rapidly begins packing up his things.
I'm gonna take a deep breath and kind of stand out the window, and I'm going to turn over. How is the sun? Is the sun coming up at this point?
I'm gonna say it's like 5-ish in the morning, so like it's starting to get. You can see the daylight peeking over the horizon, just a little bit.
All right, I'm gonna turn and I'm gonna be like, we stick out like a sore thumb. I think we should wait for the hustle of bustle in the city a little bit after the sun rises. How do you think? How do you guys feel about this?
For one, I feel like Garavik, how many times have you gone through this checkpoint before you can enter the city?
He pauses and looks up from where he was rummaging through his luggage, and dozens of times, easily. Do you mean since the droids took over or before? He says, I've been doing this for years.
Since the droids.
Easily 12 to 15 times, I'd say.
Can you handle yourself if they, like, try to do something with you?
Oh, they won't give me too much trouble, you know. They aren't too smart, them clankers.
Garavik, before you go, well, we were told of a Den Deep. He was a king of sorts of Isis. Do you know anything about
it? King Ramses Dendip. He was the king up till, well, shortly after this whole separatist mess began.
Do you know what happened to him?
He abdicated the throne, handed it over to old King Sanjay there. A rotten bastard.
You said King Sanjay?
Yeah, Sanjay Rash. That was the king that Saw was raging about last time.
What is like a common species of the city of Isis?
Mostly human. But there's some Nikto and Rodians, any of the more well-traveled species, an occasional Twi'lek or Ithorian.
Garavik, are you aware of the species that King Sanjay is? Is he human, or is he a droid?
Rash is a human, as well as I know. A droid? Do you think he's a droid?
I am just trying to get all angles of this mess. I don't want to go be...
We've been told before.
There's more sides to this coin.
Before, when we first met.
Yes. There's more sides to the story than just one, is my point. And if this King Rash is a human, it might be worth a talking to. Garavik, we've kept you long enough. Please, head on your way. We won't be here much shortly. You can tell the front desk that you can close out your room. You can speak for us as well and close out our room. It would be appreciated.
I will, Silas. Thank you. Thank you so much. He's finished packing his travel bag and walks out.
Gervik, before you go, can I have my comm?
Hi. Hi, Master Jedi.
Thank you.
And he hands it back to you there.
Cool. I'll like spin on my heel back to everybody else. I say we have about an hour before the sun comes up fully, and all of the merchants and the common people of Isis will be walking about. Gives us a little bit of cover, rather than right now currently when everybody is still sleeping. I say we clean our weapons, make sure everything is tip-top shape. I have a bit of a meditation to do with Sar. I say we leave in an hour. How does that sound?
Sounds yeah, like I a agree. Plan, Crow.
I think we should go speak with Saw and Master Crass. We can get into contact with Saw and figure out their location exactly.
Assuming their heads didn't get split from all the drinking yesterday.
Exactly. It is a little. That's another reason why I think we should wait a little bit. It's pretty early. Not many tend to wake up as early as us that we have this fine night.
You see Sar go and walk off to, like, the middle of the living room and sit down and start meditating.
And I will join him. You actually see, like, when Silas begins meditating, it takes a few moments before he actually starts levitating off of the ground. And I'm going to use force recovery. I can use it on a short rest, and I can regain force points equal to half my consular level plus my wisdom. So that's 5 plus 5, so I gain 10 force points back. AJ, just while we are meditating, I would like to just kind of look into the future of the day, if I can. I just want to get like just a general sense of our mission, you know, any good thoughts. I'm really reaching out in the force, trying to sense any negative energy or anything like that.
You sense a lot of tension, like there's something lingering over what you have seen. You have a feeling of a darkness that you can't quite put your finger on.
Do you feel that, Sar? The darkness in the center of the city. It's cloudy. Now, do I think this is the dark side?
It seems just like a almost like a void in your vision. Like if you're setting, if you're imagine in your meditation, you see like an aerial view of the city, but you can't see anything where the palace is. It stands just a cloud.
Darkness shrouds over the palace. We must be very careful this day.
You guys actually notice that Sar's whole body starts like twitching and he starts like mumbling sort of, and he's like remembering his past a little bit, and he comes out of meditation in like sweat and deep breathing.
And I'll just reach out with my hand and I'll slowly like sink to the floor and my eyes pop open. And I just put my hand on your shoulder and I'll just give you like a little bit of a squeeze and nod at you, because like I when we meditate together, it's very bonding, you know, we almost see the same thing, and I can enhance your feelings in the force as well, so I just can console you a little bit, and I'll stand up. Much better. Are you all ready?
Yes, Master.
Rick and Josma, what did you do while they were meditating?
I was probably just keeping a eye on the streets, like from our room, just make sure that there's no suspicious activity going on.
I was keeping an eye on the door to make sure nobody was about to kick it in and blast us with tasers, and in my free time between that, just working on form of sword, obviously with not without the blade, mostly just with the hilt.
Beautiful. Josmo out the window would be into the alley again. You do see a little bit of early morning activity, just looks like people getting up and heading out to the day. The market stalls are nearby, and there appear to be several merchants heading out to start setup for the day.
Alrighty.
But nothing to be concerned about.
Okay. I'd probably, like, if I was just out on the windowsill, I'd probably, like, go back into the room and let the others know. But if I was out in, like, the city streets, I'd, like, go back to the hotel room using the fire escape and let them know that way.
Well, are you resting in the hotel room with them? Or are you, do you want to go out in the streets?
Yeah, I'll probably go out in the streets.
Okay, so if you're going back down the fire escape, then give me just a minute. I will pull up the merchant quarter map a little bit closer in there. And you're going to be about here coming out.
Just to be clear, are we still in meditation right now?
Yeah, this is during the time that you were meditating, I believe, is what he said. So which are you, like, walking through the market or just through the back alleys? Yeah. Or
I'm walking through the back alleys.
Yeah, like I said, you before you see mostly just people getting ready to come up for work. There's not a whole lot of traffic through this particular alley.
Alrighty. So yeah, seeing as how I don't see any suspicious activity, I start making my way back to the hotel room.
Okay. Did you guys just leave the window open or something? Or are you gonna call back or?
I shut it.
So you're shutting the window, even though he's most likely going to come back up here and forget which room it is. I open it right back up so we don't have to deal with the same situation we dealt with that, like, an hour ago.
Don't listen to him. We're meditating.
And I look out the window to see if I... Yeah. Well, he's just talking then. I look out. Do I see Josmo working his way back up the fire escape?
Yeah, if you're looking out, you see him. He sees you. You're back up. What are we doing? So the Jedi are waking up from meditation.
Salus and Zar have their little scene right there, and then I'll kind of turn
you about
around.
Ready, Crow?
Yeah, I believe so. And you?
Yeah, as ready as we're going to be. Now let's go meet up with the hunter. See if we can't find out more. Assuming him and his ally aren't still drunker than a starfish on the moons of Toph.
If I remember correctly, Master Crass did tell us where he was staying. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, so I think...
Yep. He even offered to let you... His address.
Yeah, I think we'll just probably head there then.
Alright. So we will... Back to the big map. So you start to... are you leaving through the front or the fire escape?
I think at this time we should probably... What do you guys think? You guys think we should be secretive or just be...
leave through the front.
Yeah, I kind of agree. We can get out the room and stuff.
Plus, if we leave through the fire escape, they could always... either way, we're in a situation we could get routed out. If we never appear from the fire escape, they can track us down if we don't make an appearance in the front. So either way, it's kind of a gamble. So we could take the front just to keep suspicions of the overall hotel to minimum.
I agree.
Before we leave, I actually go up and I hug Master Crow and I say, did you see it?
See what?
My past, everything.
I didn't see anything, I just can feel your confliction. Mind your feelings, don't let them get in the way of today's events. Okay?
Yes, Master.
Let's go before we spend too much time here and have them bring in droids to kick us out, in which case we'll have to cut down this whole hotel. We have a mission to complete. Let's go see if the drunks are awake. All
right, I'll follow Drake.
I will follow as well.
I shall also follow.
As you make your way back through the lobby, you see just a few people out getting the breakfast slop going. There's a Rodian who seems to be taking over the night shift from a droid at the front counter. As you walk down the stairs, he shuts down the droid and shoves it in a closet. And then turns around and sees you there and says, oh, hi. How can I help you?
We're just leaving. We stayed here last night. Perfect accommodations. We couldn't thank you much more. This is a perfect place to lay our head after a good night drink. Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much. Don't forget to hop on the HoloNet and leave us a good review.
Will do.
As you walk outside, you see merchants setting up their stalls, various knickknacks for sale, and fruit vendors, and other various stuff. And you want to head towards Crass's place?
Yeah, we told them we'd meet up with them.
Discreetly, yes.
Are you just going to head over there?
Yeah. Obviously, we'll try to blend with the crowd.
Discreetly.
Best we can.
Okay. Things are starting to get stirring up here in the merchant quarter, and there are people coming through the... coming in from the different areas, and you would head up this way through a street full of shops over here, and as you work your way up towards the residential sector, you do see over by the defense tower, there is a small patrol of battle droids, B1s, about six of them, just marching, not really bothering anyone.
Breakfast. keep your heads down. Drake, keep your eyes behind us, make sure we're not being followed.
I do just that.
Make a perception.
All right.
That would be 18.
You do see, you do notice as you walk away from the hotel and you turn around and peek and see that the Rodian you just spoke to had his head peeking out the door for a second, and then when he saw you looking back very quickly, retreated.
That Rodian was looking a little too close at us, so we need to be a little more discreet in getting the hell out of here, Crow.
Good eye, Drake. Just keep your eye out for anything else.
I'll keep more than an eye out. Maybe more than your eye, too. You cyborg-sided fool.
You still think you're funny?
Oh, I know I am.
As you make your way closer to the residential quarter, you see this early in the morning, there's many more people heading out into the various work districts than in. So you're fighting against the crowd a little bit. But you do, after a few minutes, make it through and up to the address that that Sir Crass left you.
All right. So we see the building in front of us?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to like just kind of look around. Is there like an alleyway that's right next to the building?
Yeah, there's an alley on either side.
Okay, I say we go, I'm going to start walking over to the left, and I'm just going to be like, follow me. And I'm going to head towards the alley in between the two buildings on the left. And as soon as I get around, as soon as we get around the bend, I'm going to like hug up against the side of Master Crass's building. And I'm going to wait a couple seconds, and then I'm going to peek out and see if anybody followed us.
You don't see, there doesn't appear to be anyone immediately, like, watching you that you can see, or, nobody, like, followed you into the alley. You just see a bunch of people, like I said, it's mostly people heading out, and very few people heading in.
All right,
You and what appears to be a couple of very tired night shift workers.
All right, I'll look those workers up and down, try to get a read on them. If nothing, I'm going to wait here for like another minute, and then I'll nod. The coast is clear.
Yeah, you don't see anything too suspicious.
All right, so after a moment passes, I'll be like, all right, I think we're good. And I'll pop out and go knock on the door.
I keep like my hand on my saber just in case.
As you knock on the door, a small robotic voice comes from a nearby speaker and says, "Welcome to Isis Heights. Please say the name of the resident you are here to visit."
I'll like bend down and push the button. Crass.
Now ringing the room for Dale Crass.
I just roll my eyes to everybody.
And at the you get a ringtone for a moment. Beep. 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 And then a click, and suddenly a... Hello? Hello?
Crass, this is Jedi Master Silas and my three crows. How's it going this morning?
Bro!
I think you're pretty funny, man.
Lord. Crow, get up here. And he buzzes you up and the door pops.
Alright, we'll enter. As I smile at Drake.
I think you're pretty funny.
Yeah, I follow
his crows, don't you, Silas?
I know I'm funny.
I'm about ready to take your wrist box.
As you enter the building, three doors up the hall pops open, and Crass staggers halfway out the door and waves to you.
I'll wave back. How are you feeling?
And then he says rather loudly, you would note for what he's saying, "Hey, shut the fuck up and get in here."
I would take your own advice after you.
You note that he said that much louder than you said anything. As he waves you all inside the tiny cramped apartment, you see Saw Gerrera passed out on the couch.
I'm gonna walk inside, and then does he have any windows or anything?
Yeah, there's it's a very small apartment. Think like your old apartment, James. There's a little tiny kitchen with a balcony over on the outside, and just a couple small windows.
All right, I just kind of want to move the blinds a little bit and just kind of just look out as I turn. I know it's a little early, but our mission was rather successful. It did exactly what we wanted to do.
Right, of course. And he blinks a few times. And what was that again?
Well, Sarah, why don't you tell him?
We have 48 hours.
Drake.
Yeah, go ahead, kid.
Everything, all the anti-aircraft and port. The port accepts everything for 48 hours, and all anti-aircraft is shut down for 48 hours.
His eyes grow wide. 48 hours? Oh, we have to move now. Have you already called the Republic? Are they on their way?
No, we came to inform you first.
Oh, well, we must get to work immediately. He walks over and starts slapping Saw in the face. Get up, man! Get up! We only have 48 hours before the siege starts.
Oh my god.
I go and fill a glass of water, and I want to go just ice cold water, and I just go and toss it in Saw Gerrera's face. Still holding onto the cup, just the water douses him, his face.
He wakes up sputtering and spitting and swinging. What's your AC?
15.
Doesn't matter. He wakes up and swings at you and lunges at you off the couch and falls straight on his face.
And I'll be like, guess who?
As he looks up at you from the floor, he says, Silas, Lord, that drink you bought us was strong.
Yeah, we need to work on that, don't we?
Get up! Everything's shut down for 48 hours.
He covers his ears for a second. He's like, stop shouting!
Jocelyn kind of like puts his hand on his head and is like, The boy's right, though. We do need to start moving quickly.
I'll just kind of, like, bend over. You get sensitivity in your hangover. Our mission, Saw, was rather successful. It was pretty easy, actually. The entire spaceport was hardly guarded, and the guard that was there was, well, occupied. A little bit preoccupied, we can say that. We successfully made it to where we have the next 48 hours to have any ship come in and out as we please.
Any 48 hours? We have to call your Jedi commanders, and this is amazing. He begins to comprehend what you said. We lost Drake on roll 20.
Oh no.
I'm still here. Let me figure out.
Okay.
Figure out what's going on.
That's okay. As he begins to realize and comprehend exactly what you said, he turns to you, Sara, and goes to give you a great big hug.
Yes, I'm quite proud of my Padawan. Rather handy with the tech.
Do you know how many lives you've saved? I thought we were gonna have to besiege my own city from the outside, but if we can attack from the air, we can call in the Republic. We could bring in the Drexels. We could fly right up to the palace.
Joshua kind of like thinks himself.
Well, we're on a time
like,
clock.
Off from the. Joshua's kind of like off to the side and is like, "Is this man crazy or something?"
No, he's quite sane. He's just hungover.
We're on a time limit, so obviously we need to move fast. On all counts, ours and yours and the Republic's, if we're gonna take it. If there's any other things we need to do, whether it's meeting the old king to usurp the new and capturing the usurper, we need to figure out how to do that quick, since we're under now slightly under than 48 hours, so we must move fast.
I don't want to siege the city with all the civilians here. We need to evacuate it.
Of course, I'll need to contact my agents and start them moving, but we have to know exactly when the attack comes, because if everyone starts leaving the city, they'll become suspicious.
That's exactly what I was going to say. If the droids start to see the people moving, they're going to know something's up, and then the plan is shot.
We need to come up with a plan. Master Kress.
I have one.
Go speak your mind, Drake. Speak your mind.
We need to lay. We have 48 hours before the gunners come back online. Within that time, we need to have the flights, Drexels, and all of our people come in to try and take back the city. We need to get as many civilians out as possible, but without alerting the droids. So my suggestion is, while we're all trying to get while they're trying to get that ready, we need to, in a combination, find out where the original king is imprisoned, possibly rescue him, and in that, distract the droids with that mission, and to further keep them distracted within the 48 hours, we need to capture the usurper. That will lead the droids, let's be honest, distracted, coming after us, but it will leave the rest of the Republic to quickly take over and take down the majority of the droids in the city, allowing those civilians to escape. It's a plan that'll put us all in danger, our group mostly, but I think it's our best bet.
I think you're on to something there, Drake. Go ahead, Jasma.
Jasma kind of like looks at Son and is like, is there by chance an underground like labyrinth or something that we can send the civilians to until after the siege is done?
I'm afraid not. Not many basements in Isis.
I do like where you're going with this.
Like my plan might have to be.
if we could, the most. Go ahead.
What do you suggest? Continue suggesting. If you have anything that can make our plan safer, Earth, and I'm all ears.
Okay. My thought is Drakenstar, Master Crow. Okay. If me and Jasmo go on a mission to sneak into the palace and try to capture the king, and maybe it would give us some edge on the siege, and we could find out intel from the king. But I would need the most sneakiest top elite assassins to come with.
Assassins?
It's...
That palace is the most heavily guarded place on all of Onderon.
That's why we need to sneak in and get this king.
Sire, we're not killing anyone. That is not the Jedi way.
I know, Master.
So why do you say assassin?
Tongue slipped. Someone...
I think the boy means somebody who can infiltrate him. I think the boy meant infiltration, as I give him a kind of questionable look.
I agree.
I give the young DeGruta a questionable look, and then I cover him by saying, I think he meant somebody who's especially good with infiltration. Being sneaky, capable of getting in and out despite the most highly guarded areas.
I believe that qualifies all four of us. I think a combination of everyone's plans has been given me a bit of an idea. I think it will be rather big news, or distraction, if you will, when a bunch of flying Drexels and the Republic ships come and fly to infiltrate the city, don't you? I think whilst all of this is happening, we need to get into contact with most of the civilians to find a safe place, whether that be, you know, their own homes, wherever it can be. Unfortunately, I don't believe within our time limit we can dictate much. However, in this, wherein all the ships are landing, I think that will make a very good distraction, hopefully weakening the defenses, or at least their attention at the palace, so that we can slip in the back and get a better handle on what exactly is going on. I don't want to dethrone a king to only replace him for someone who will be worse for the city. We don't know all that there is to know about this story. We do know that this King Sanjay Rash is obviously with the separatists. That automatically gives him a negative point in our book. However, we haven't spoken to this Ramses character, nor have we spoken to Sanjay. I think we need to have a conversation with both of these. Don't you agree?
Jasmo,
either way, we need to find,
like,
both kings.
Jasmo kind of like looks between Drakenstar and you, Crow, and he's like, "While that is a good idea, Master Jedi, do you really think that speaking with a separatist leader could end well for us?"
I think he will be rather...
There's a reason it's called...
I think we will put him in a tight spot. Agreed. We are threatening his city with a mass invasion. We are going to try to... We're going to... I hate to say this, but if need be, we could deceive him. If he's simply a man doing his job, that might be easier than expected. However, if he's been tricked, or if this is all a trap, which my senses are kind of telling me this, then we can deal with that when we come to that. Agreed?
Agreed, Master.
Just one question.
All I know...
You first,
Rakan. All I know is... Like I was saying... Cross, you've served under both kings. And we're putting a lot of faith in your word, which is a lot for the amount of betrayal we've had over the years. No offense. What would you say, who of the two kings would be more respectable for the people of this planet? Because it's hard to get rid of, try and take from one devil to give to another.
He lets out a deep sigh and says, my personal slights aside, having over losing my job, I would still serve under King Dendup any day. Rash has done nothing but sell off Onderon's natural resources to fund the separatist war, where in my lifetime the Republic had mostly left us alone.
I'm sorry we dragged you into this. Well, you've been dragged into this mess, rather, but we're here to help, Master Crass. We're gonna go and speak with Dendup. Do you know if he is free, walking about, or if he's in custody?
I'm afraid he's imprisoned in the palace dungeon.
So let me get this straight. Old King was usurped by this new Sanjay. They imprisoned the previous king in the dungeons.
Aye, they told the public that he abdicated the throne, but I was there.
I think that answers most of my questions last night. I have for Sanjay. Don't you guys agree?
Yeah, and I remember him telling us last night at the bazaar, so apparently somebody had a little too much to drink, eh, Crow? Your tolerance aside, it affected that memory of yours just a smidgen. So, best bet is we have to get into the castle, free the old king, probably take a political hostage of the new king, And during all that commotion and distraction, the droids will most likely be too distracted to while Crass and Saul here end up trying to get the city cleared for the reinforcements to come in. I think that's our best bet for a plan. Anything else?
Jossmo kind of like perks up and is like, what do we do if we've been betrayed?
This might be the end of Saul. What am I about to do? Guys,
what do we always do when we're betrayed? Cut through everything.
There's something I need to say.
Speak your mind.
I still have the sap and grenades, and the castle's gonna be heavily guarded. Maybe I could plant the grenades and make it to where the castle's less guarded and get you a better shot at this. This might be, if I do go through with this plan, this might be the last time you see me.
I think you're overthinking this, child. I think you need to save some of those grenades, because like Jossmo said, if we're betrayed and we're inside enemy lines in the castle or dungeon, we might need those grenades to blow holes through the walls to escape, or at the very least cover us. And like you said previously, young Togruta, we need to get in there very sneakily, be quiet and make sure we work our way in. So don't try and sacrifice yourself yet. We're not that far in.
I have a sneaking suspicion that the influx of our friends will be a very convincing argument for us to slip in the back. Don't you agree?
I agree.
Then we best get started. We're on a ticking time clock, and it's only getting less by each moment we're here discussing. So we best get going, Crow.
All right, I'm going to pull out my comm, and I am going to just push a tracking beacon on my comm, and we'll say like that's the signal that I gave that me and Master Windu discussed, or whoever my superior was, I don't think we quite said, that's the signal to cue the Republic that the, that we're ready. And then I'll just kind of slip my comm back in my robes, and I'll say, "Saw, I think you should tell your Drexel friends to come as soon as possible while the day is young. And we should make a mess of this, don't you agree?"
A giant smile erupts on Saw's face. "I've dreamt of this day. I never thought it would come so soon." And he runs to get... runs to one of the bedrooms to grab something.
I'm gonna move the castle house garden.
And you can hear him making calls in the other room.
That leaves one issue left. The civilians. I'm assuming the City of Isis has speakers implanted throughout the city, and I think a certain someone could transmit a bit of a warning to get to cover as soon as possible upon a reaction. Do you think you could do this, Saw?
But remember, he'd have to try and hack it in such a way that the droids couldn't pick up on the message. It would only be able to be heard through the organic beings. So it is trickier.
I agree. I just find it nearly impossible to have a conversation with each individual person. Have you seen the size of the city? I think a mass communication is the better option. And plus, we have limited time, so I think this is the better way to do this.
Grass, agree,
but if he can...
sorry. Go ahead.
No, I was just agreeing.
Okay. Grass would like to interject at this point and say, if we can attack the, or if we can take the throne room, we could use the emergency broadcast system to send a message to all of the city, but the droids would obviously see that too, though. If we time it properly, then I suspect they'll be too distracted with our reinforcements to care much of the civilians.
I agree. Unfortunately, we are to... if we're to get a jump on the droids, we will have to keep the civilians out of it as well.
Yes. Josmo kind of like looks to Master Kress and is like, "Does this city have any security forces that are not droids?"
All the droids.
They're all droids?
Damn. Yeah. He shakes his head and says, "Yes, even the... alas, as I told you yesterday, even the Kingsguard have now been replaced by the CIS droid forces."
What about the former King's forces?
You all get. That's Crass.
Oh.
Yeah, you guys drink way too much. Clearly. Anyway, once we get into the throne room, like Crass suggests, we can send out a mass communication. And I'm sure young Saar here could possibly work it in a way that he could send a mass communication to the whole city while possibly hacking into the droid's frequency to make sure they can't hear what is being said. It'd be trickier for Saar, but either way, our reinforcements from the Republic and from the Drexels coming in will keep the droids distracted. I'm just trying to look as least loss of life on the planet as possible. But we need to hurry. Our time clock is running short by the moment.
At this point, I'm going to turn off my tracking beacon. And I'm going to look over at Saw. Have you gotten a hold of your friends?
He says, "I've begun contacting my agents throughout the city.
Where are you going?"
And we've begun telling those we can trust to move all they can into the into a safe area. If we can possibly, I believe our best bet would be if we can communicate that right here in the residential quarter needs to be avoided. I would rather not drop a tank on a building with 2,000 people inside.
I have good faith Josh in your friends. Kind of...
I trust everyone with my life.
Josmo kind of then looks to Saw, back to Saw after, like, giving a knowing look to Crone. Is like, during this mission, you guys are essentially going to be having to be the security forces here just to, you know, help us with the droid issue and keeping everybody safe in the city. Can you handle that?
I'll do what I can, but and Crass looks at you and says, "I need to come with you to the palace."
You know, you know how you said hack the droid's frequency and the speakers at the exact same time? That would just be too much. That's two separate things. I can't do it all just on one computer. I would need where the droids are being supplied to do the whole frequency. I can't just put them down.
In theory, Sarah, the palace would be such a place, correct?
In theory,
I'm afraid if we activate the emergency broadcast system, there's little chance of subtlety, as it does transmit voice and video via the news at the Hollow news centers across the city. Everyone in the city will hear your message.
Agreed. At that point, subtlety will be out the window. It's more, we need to get in there quietly with the distraction of our friends landing in the spaceport.
Unfortunately, this is war. We can save as many as we can, but there will be lives lost. Unfortunately, that's just the sacrifice we can make. All we can do is try and reduce that.
Well, I think we've had enough chit-chat.
As much as we can.
I think we should try to slip off and get an advantage. I think we should slip off and get an advantageous spot outside of the palace and wait for our signal.
I say, hold on.
Crass, you said you knew the way.
We're wasting time, boy.
What do you need?
Okay. We're sneaking into the palace. There has to be a map of the city showing all of the sewers and all that. Maybe there has to be something.
He said there are none.
There are no sewers.
It's called us raging the castle is what's going to cause the biggest distraction. That's why we need you to save as many of those explosives as we can. Some for an escape and some for a distraction so we can lead the droids there. Once we free the king and try and capture the free the old king and capture the new one, the droids will be too focused on us to pay much attention to all the civilians, in which case Crass Saul's men will come in and try and rescue as many as they take over. When the Republic comes in, that's when the real hellfire will rain from the skies. So we are on a time limit. The more we discuss it, we can discuss this on the way to go. We are running out of time.
I think the plan flew right over your head. I suggest we don't infiltrate the palace until our friends land. So be like, oh, look over there, and we'll slip in underneath while they're distracted. If we enter the palace beforehand, that's a suicide mission.
Yeah.
Crass says, we could charge the sky ramp, but they've been keeping a tank sitting there for the last 2 months.
Just one? Just one tank?
Yes, one tank that is in addition to the droid company guarding the two power gates.
How many droids do you know of? How many droids cross?
They were keeping a full squad of B1s and B2s last I knew.
So about 2 dozen, 4 dozen, give or take?
There's going to be a lot, Drake.
That's why 3 dozen.
That's why it's imperative
at minimum
that we wait for our Republic allies to
we could take land. The tank.
We have to take the tank. We have to take the tank.
Yes.
So that we can get someone to land a ship on that port to get us the hell out of there. Hopefully with Dendep in tow. I turn to Saw. Once you get a handle of the city and get a Drexel or maybe a flock of them, could you look for our signal at the palace to swoop us up when we take care of that tank?
I'll sneak into the palace alone. You guys head up the tank.
No. You are not going alone. Get that out of your head. That doesn't help anybody here.
Master, if I can pull it off, I can get the message to the city.
We're gonna do this together.
If we wait till all the Republic ships, half of the people here will be murdered. That's why I'm risking myself to get everyone out.
As soon as you deploy your message, our subtlety is out the window. They will know that they have a mole in the city, in the palace especially. We need to wait for our friends to land before you will be murdered, because you will be all by yourself. Is that what you want? It sounds like that's what you want.
Enough of this. All of you. He's right, Sar. Even if you were managed to get to the tank, you would get bombarded by the droids, blown up and ended if you were even lucky enough to send the message. And as for you, Crow, you're right. We need to wait a little bit, but we can't wait too long or too much lives will be at risk. So we need to start moving and making a plan on how we get how to commune with the old king in the dungeon. We can't seize the current king until everything goes in place. This all needs to be timed out perfectly.
I'm wondering.
And as long as the Republic is sending forces now, is the Republic sending somebody now? You have you already communicated with your comm, correct?
Yeah. AJ, did I hear back from them?
At this point, you receive a ping on your comm that says you have 10 hours.
All right. I'm going to turn to and I'm going to be like, they're not going to be here for another 10 hours. Listen.
Oh, no.
There's another speed bump. I'm just wondering, do you think warning the civilians is even necessary? Don't you think any sane individual will not take cover once their city is being invaded? I think that it's almost irrelevant at that point.
It's a risky move. But I see no other choice in the matter.
So how long until your Drexel allies could get here? Because the rebellion won't be here, or the Republic won't be here for another 10 hours.
Saw looks over at Sir Crass and says, "We need to call Gwar now." And with a look of concern on his face for just a moment, he nods and goes to make a call.
Josmo is kind of like confused, and so he asks Saw, "Pardon me, who?"
Gwar is our beastmaster ally. He is one of our only supporters among the Beast Rider clans. But He's how we have access to those three Drexels. I certainly could not control one without him.
I have an idea. We're all worried about this 48-hour window.
No.
We already know that the spaceship is hardly guarded at nighttime. I think we should go scope out the palace. Just kind of get a gauge on things. Wait until... We have to wait until 10 o'clock, or 10 hours from now. We could easily slip back in and try to extend the duration. I don't like that plan, but I'm just throwing that out there.
Do you think what about our plans?
Still speak with the Emperor. Speak with the imprisoned king. Where does that line up in our 10 to 48 hour plan?
The problem is how do we get in there? The place is crawling with droids.
That's why I think one of us gets arrested.
That's why I have an idea.
I love splitting.
Let's hear it, Crow.
We need to go check out the palace. Sure. And
are you gonna get him arrested?
We need to. I think I could fit in the suit of a B2 battle droid. Do you, Sar? It might be a little weird, but I think we could pull it off. We could pretend that this bastard Drake right here is a prisoner and we're taking him in.
I'm good with that plan. And if they need you to prove you're a droid, that cybernetic eye of yours would work perfectly for identification.
Or we could go back and we could try to reprogram those 6 B2s that we passed on the way in. We could have them be, you know, all of us imprisoned. You could tell them, Saw, you could have them gain us entry. We could pretend to be handcuffed, though of course we wouldn't be, until we get to the bottom of the palace, and that's our entry.
I could wire a lot.
I still like the idea. We should do that, Crow, but I still like the idea of disguising you as a droid, too, just in case somebody were able to reboot them and they actually did try to arrest us on the spot. We'd have you there to start blasting or cutting them down while, in case the jump of surprise. Like one of your rules said, always have the element of surprise. Right, Crow?
The element of surprise would be that none of us are really prisoners.
Josmo kind of like looks
yes,
over
but
to you, Crow.
And... Don't forget the.
You first, don't forget what? Drakenstar.
Don't forget that the systems in the city could always reboot droids at any time. So anything that the boy here hacks into, even if we hacked all them in, they got us right inside the city gates, right to the dungeon. If for some reason, for any reason, just for the hell of it, any of the main systems were to reboot the droids, that would put their whole system back online, would it not? But if you were disguised as a droid, also with the other droids holding us prisoner, then in case they were to be rebooted, we could take them out then and there without them knowing you were off the grid. So maybe, and plus it would keep us even more element of surprise if all the prisoners we're all prisoners while you're still one of our guards. Just an idea. If you don't want to dress as a droid, I understand. I know how you're iffy with cybernetics already, minus that eye of yours, Crow.
I wonder if they have a human-cyborg relations, you know, like a C3 unit or something that I could put its armor on myself, and that would be a little bit better than those B2s. Either way, I think we need to go investigate the palace just to go see.
Grass, do you know anything about all this? Yeah, and then we need to hack those other B1s or B2s we saw earlier in the street and then go from there. So I'm agreeing with, I like this plan better. It's safer for all of us and it'll get us in the castle better.
And if we get caught,
are we still
going to
try and all be prisoners or do you just want...
I think it's best if
I get taken prisoner.
If we can
that
all
way it saves
be
the rest of the group
into,
the issue if, of risk.
If we can all be disguised, then obviously that'll be the better route, but... If we get in and we get discovered, the worst case scenario is we have to fight our way through.
Crass kind of like
has been sitting here in silence while you guys talk and says, speaks up and says, Sorry, he hasn't been. He was making a call for a minute and came back into the room to you guys arguing. And he says, "If you want to get arrested, I'll put away your lightsabers. I'll walk right over to the next patrol I see and throw a B1 to the ground and have you in the dungeons in no time."
Really?
I think if we could hide our blades, we could hopefully get out rather simply, don't you?
I mean, it's possible, but there's one other thing.
I tuck mine. What's okay. That?
I think we should do that. General Crass, will you be so kind as to come with us to the nearest patrol that we passed earlier? If we can, lead them into an alley to get a jump on them. I think we should try to... Here's our options. We can either just get arrested, all of us. I could try to manipulate them into believing I'm some sort of an ambassador for the Separatists. I think I can pull it off. They're just droids. They're not smart. So I will probably be good. I don't know if I could save you guys. Plan B would be we jump all of the B2s, dismantle them, and put the armor on ourselves, and do our original plan where us pretend droids have Drake as a prisoner.
My opinion, that's probably the best plan. That way it leads a less destructive wake on you, on the rest of you. And then I'm the only one truly exposed. And you know me, I can take a little firefight. In my opinion, I think we should do that. Dismantle, disguise, and take me as prisoner. And okay. Maybe hack a couple droids just so they can help lead us way to the dungeon.
Alrighty. Then go ahead, Jasmo.
As Osmo was trying to say before, he is like, if we do that, though, and we have our allies come in within 10 hours and whatnot, what happens if, like, the, you know, patrols go by the place that we went to last night and notice that something's been hacked with or something?
That won't be our concern at that point. By that point,
the boy covered his tracks. And the boy covered his tracks last night when he hacked into the system. I remember he emphasized that. This is what happens when the two of you drink too much. You're clever, you're up to the task, but you're so forgetful in the morning.
Fair enough.
All right, then I think you all should hide in the alley, and I will get the attention of the droids, and we'll jump them.
Alrighty then.
We gotta be careful not to try and destroy too much of them, and maybe at least leave one or two intact to help us lead us to the dungeon, as long as the boy hacks its brain and makes it under our control.
Make our grenades into I could make our grenades into.
There's an appropriate alley, I believe, two blocks west of here that would serve us well.
No.
Says Crass.
I agree with you, Crass. Point the door, don't point the way. And I'll follow across.
He looks down at his still dirty clothes from last night and stutters for a moment. You're right. Let's go. And grabs his blaster from the table where it was just sitting openly, and grabs it and marches straight out the door.
All right, I follow.
I'll have to check my hair condition.
I too follow.
I'm right behind Master Crow.
And Saw says, as you leave, I have a couple more calls to make, and then I'm gonna and then I'll wait for your signal.
You got it.
As we start heading out, I try and get a hold of Crow a little bit behind the rest of the group before we get too close to the alley coming up. Silas, you and I need to have a quick chat real quick. A little quiet one, kind of letting everybody else get a little bit of space. So me and the old Crow here can have a little discussion.
All right, I'll kind
sorry
of
for
back.
The secrecy here, Crow, but sorry for the secrecy here, Crow. I'm not trying to keep our group secret, but you know how it is. It's hard to trust alliances with anybody nowadays. Probably know Kras could be leading us into a trap. Ever since that incident with Fixer all those years ago, it's kind of hard to trust your allies, you know?
I understand, but I haven't gotten a reading from Master Kras. He seems like a genuine person.
Nevertheless, what we've been discussing the last few years, this king, this whole planet, the reason we're on it, with all his droids here, the Separatists, would they be in an alliance with the Sith by chance?
Yeah. At this point, I think I would basically know about Count Dooku, and I would kind of explain.
Yeah. To him, it would be open knowledge at this point in the war. The Jedi, at least, he's not coming out and saying, hey, I'm a Sith Lord, but all the Jedi consider him a Sith Lord. Yeah. And as far as they know, he is the Sith Lord.
Yeah, so I would basically kind of explain that to you, Drake.
After that incident, when we first found out about Dooku's treachery, when we first met years ago, letting Windu know about all everything. If they're allied with the Sith, obviously I'm not a Jedi, and my weapon definitely leaves many of your brethren to question. I've heard the jeers and comments in the mess halls over the years, how I'm always stared at with a little bit of disconcern by the rest of your Republic. I know you and the boy have tried to keep those rumors quiet, but even I hear things between corners. So what if, other than if things go really awry, what I'm suggesting is, say our plan goes to hell once we take me in as a prisoner and you're all dressed up as droids. If everything truly goes to hell, what if I make the assumption that I'm part of the Sith and that I brought you all into capture only as a last resort, just to try and buy allegiance to buy us time, if not our lives? This is just a secondary plan I want you and me to know, because then we don't need the rest of the group being AWOL about it. You and I would know, and you and I are best with keeping these kind of secrets. Jasmo, good man he is, has definitely let it slip a few times, and the boy definitely gets emotional, and this would only ensue his belief in that. It's only if your plan with taking me in as a prisoner and you all being disguised as the droids go to shit. You understand what I'm saying, don't you, Crow?
This whole time, I'm like just kind of stroking my beard and I like resting my hand on my chin. And I'll just look at you dead in the eye and give you a nod. And then walk off.
Perfect. All right, let's go. And then as soon as we catch up to the group, I just make a comment. And that, keep walking, you spider-eyed cretin. That's what you get for calling me that. You know, trying to play it off like I was just trying to bullshit with him so the rest of the group isn't as suspicious.
I'll just wink at Sar.
Fair enough.
This is an important note for me. Do you wink with your robot eye or your regular eye?
My fucking human eye, you fuck.
Very important information. All right. You're staying out in the open, and the rest of them are going into the alley. Is that right, Silas?
Yeah. So
I understand that right, guys?
Yeah. So I was basically just going to be like, "Hey, look over here," and kind of make a distraction, and then we'll have them surrounded in theory.
Okay.
So awesome. I would like kind of make sure you guys are like as far back in the alley as possible so that they run down the alley a little bit and then we can pounce.
Yeah, there's the alley that he takes you to is great. There's like there's a crossroads in the alley where it's two alleys that cross each other, and there's like trash cans right at the corners.
All right, I'm gonna kind of wait until everybody gets into position.
I get into position.
How tall is the building right next to us?
I'd say all of these buildings that you're next to are like apartment buildings. So they're like 5 or 6 stories at least. This is the residential area. Most of the city's population is crammed into these tightly fit buildings.
Okay, so is there a fire escape? Or like...
Yeah, there would be fire escapes above you.
Okay. I was just
leading curious. Down into the alley where you're at.
Alright, I was just curious. Alright, so what I want to do is I go to... So, Master, are they coming to the split?
I'm not even anywhere near you, dude.
They're most likely coming to the split, so... I would like to take cover, like, right around that corner on the right side.
Okay.
And then I'll make it look like I'm having a confrontation with Crass and Josmo.
I'm, like, out on the street.
Like, I'm one of the planetary thugs trying to take something, get the destroyed, distract enough to come over and try and intercept us. Buy us plenty of distraction time to take care of it. I'm assuming Crass is in the alley with me and Josmo, correct? Or is he with or is he with Sila?
Crass is there hiding with you behind a dumpster.
Alright, so what's the plan? Should I make it look like I'm trying to mug the two of you, or should we just stay in hiding till we jump them? What do you two think?
I'll do whatever you two want to do.
Crass,
I'm not really good with
planning. You're a soldier here. What do you think? Well, you're a soldier.
I think
Josmo.
The element of surprise is always valuable.
Well, then, we just wait. Let's just hope the droids don't get smart and try and blast him for leading them onto a random spot in the alley. So we all hide behind the dumpster then. I stay ready just in case I need to distract the droids. I'm thinking in case they think this is some kind of weird game and they try and take Crow in without it, I'll get ready to provide a distraction. Do we hear the droids start clinking around the corner? Yep.
I was waiting for James to say something.
All right, so I'm just kind of been like kind of standing in the middle of the street at the end of the alley.
Myself, come on. Bro.
Looking back and forth, and I'm looking for, I don't want like a big patrol. We passed a patrol of 6 B2 battle droids earlier. I'm kind of looking for that patrol specifically.
You don't see that particular one. That was the group over guarding the tower, but you do see small patrols of B1s.
All right,
that are passing once in a while.
All right, I kind of want the B2s, so I'm going to run over to the battle turret, and I'm just going to kind of see if how many, I'm going to count how many B2s are over there.
There are 6 still.
Okay. All right. So I run up and I'm like, oh no. Please, please hurry. The children, the woman, hurry, follow me, please.
Civilians in danger.
Yes, all civilians, please. And I'm like running and I'm going to grab the droid and I'm like going to kind of like try to pull him.
As it tries to shake you off a little bit, one of the other droids recoils and is visibly confused by your action.
Please. And it's all, man, he's going to kill my wife, my children. I need you now. Please. And I'm going to run off.
Calm yourself, citizen, as the droid shakes off and they begin marching after you.
All right, I'm gonna do a jog. I'm not sprinting, but I wanted them to make sure, you know, they're keeping up pace, and I'm not gonna go around any corners or anything until I clearly see that they're following me. And I'm like, please,
yep,
this way.
They have you. They have you in their sights. They're speed up a little bit, and or as much as they can without like sprinting.
All right, and, we'll get up to the alley, and I'm like, We live on the second floor. This man, tall, dark robes, he broke into my window. He took my baby. He ran off down the alley. Please.
He took my baby.
Children, woman.
I'm sorry. I don't know why that's so funny.
Please.
Oh my god.
She's only 3 months old.
The Sith Lord took my baby.
You guys.
Alright. Sorry. The droids continue stoically, not cracking up, following you into the alley.
Alright, I'm gonna let them walk ahead of me, and I'm gonna act like I'm terrified. And I'm just gonna, like, be, like, 10, 15 feet behind the group of droids and follow them into the alley.
I don't see anyone, says the droid in the front. Citizen, are you sure this is the correct location?
Yeah, I live just up there. And I'll, like, point, and I'll be like, it seems like right now is a good time.
And they all look up to where you're pointing.
It seems like now would be a good time.
Okay.
That's our cue. I don't say that out loud, obviously.
Are the droids within, or do you want me to say it one more time? Droids to us, hidden behind the dumpster. Right?
No, I
jump out position. And jump and tackle three of the droids. I just straight up tackle the droids the minute you say anything. That's why I was asking if they're within range.
Good.
I just straight up tackle the droids before they even react.
All right, make an athletics check for me. Get done.
Yeah, that'd be 18.
All right, you managed to knock three of the droids to the ground.
Would you look up cryogenic blast for me?
As the others, huh? Anybody else?
I pops just... out.
I don't have disabled droid.
What roll do we need to make?
He's talking
if
to
you're...
me. I rolled an 18 for trying to tackle.
Yeah, he said he was trying to tackle him. What's everybody else doing?
I am gonna come out and try to get, like, I'm trying to act like a civilian, just trying to do a citizen's arrest of the guy.
Oh, there's my baby.
So you're acting like you're after Drakenstar?
Yeah.
Okay, so, Sar, what are you doing?
I want to jump out and say... I say, hey, what's going on? I got a family here. What's happening? Because I just hear all of this going on. And I see Jasmo chasing Dragonstar down the alley.
Did he take your baby too?
I heard a window break, so I came down here.
I'm like, give me back my baby, you bastard!
One of the droids. The droids are shocked at how. I mean, three of them are on the ground under Drakenstar, and the other three are looking confusedly at all of the civilians emerging from the alley and shouting.
And I bet they are shocked, because at this point, I'm going to say, oh, there it is! And I'm going to reach out, and I'm going to cast Disable Droid. So everything in a 15-foot cube, and I'm going to place it right in the center of all the droids, must make a Constitution saving throw.
Okay, give me just a second. The
droid con sucks.
Con saving throw? Oof. Let's see. Oh my god. One of them makes it. Everybody else rolled less than 8.
DC 17.
Wow.
Yep, I got a 21 on 1 and a 3, a 4, an 8, another 8, and a 6.
So
can we argue the one that didn't?
Yeah, I'm going to say the one that made his save is sitting under Drakenstar.
Perfect. One of the droids kind of like have like
down so it can fire.
An electrical shock about them, and they are all paralyzed.
Beautiful. The remaining droids seize up and fall to the ground. And Drake, you're just holding one down, pinned. And the other two have gone limp.
I'm just saying this all now. You all suck at acting. Right now, the only one of you who made it work so well was Crow got them here. The rest of you, as I see frickin' Jasmo trying to almost hold on to my part of my blackened cloak, I was like, let go of me, sniper.
Do it. Sorry. Okay. Immediately let go of your robes.
All right, so I want to use Greater Hologram. And I want to toss in, like, the center of us, and I want it to look like a regular alley.
And how big is the projection there, does it say?
James is looking it up right now.
My bad.
You got Greater Hologram is...
Write down the...
20-foot cube.
I think it's probably big enough.
It's a 20-foot cube.
Okay. 20 feet cube. Yeah, you're good. Beautiful. Wow. All right, you are sitting here with your bounty of droids. And no one from the outside can see anything.
Okay, I'm going to ignite my blade, and you see me just... cut from the elbow, from the armpits of the droid, all the way down its side, and freeing its chest piece, the front and back, and then I want to try to free the legs as well as the arms, so it makes like a suit.
I'm gonna allow it. Let's do it.
All right.
Hell yeah.
And ideally I'll do that for each of us.
I'm trying to think of what I want to do. I'm just going to allow it. Fuck rolling for it. Let's just do it.
Okay, so I will dismantle...
I'm still holding down the...
Perfect. I will dismantle five droids, and make armor for each of us. And then the final droid, I say, we need to reprogram this one to give us a little bit of an alibi. Sar, can you reprogram this into... tricking it into believing that we have Drake as a prisoner. I believe Drake has it held down for you already, so it shouldn't be too difficult. And I'll, like, kind of slip on my droid armor.
I want to walk up, and I just power off the droid. Make this a bit easier, so I don't have to work around this big man. And I want to try to, like, get to the memory board and make it seem like it is taking Drakenstar as a prisoner.
Do you have any powers to help with that, or are we just going to do a tech check?
Let's just do a tech check.
Alright. It's going to be tough. Go ahead and roll.
Tech is technology plus 10.
19.
Oh man. You do it. You got it. You successfully... It's okay. Sorry, Abby was trying to start a video for Reese and accidentally broadcast it to the TV I'm using.
Nice.
It's all good.
How's it going, Sarah? Can you do it?
It's done.
I'm so proud of you.
And I go and slip on my droid armor. Power it on.
I slip on my droid armor.
I'll just power it on last before we start moving.
As Crass is gonna need a hand fitting into his. He has a bit of a gut. He's gonna having some trouble fitting into the improvised breastplate.
No, Crass, hold it. Yep. Deep breath. Drake squeeze his belly a bit. Ah, there it is. Wow.
All right, so there you stand, five of the jankiest battle droids you've ever seen in your life, all different heights.
Oh my!
With bits of robe sticking out.
We look awesome.
Oh God!
Climb. You all couldn't take your robes off before that you did this, could you?
Oh.
Not by the Jedi way.
You're all idiots. I'm just saying this now.
We just have to get past the droids.
I'm gonna scream, you're all idiots. But that's all right.
I'm gonna walk up to him, like all yeah. Like my arms and legs are all straight. Come here, civilian. Arms out, bastard. And I'm gonna slap. I'm gonna slap some cuffs on Drake.
Oh, you're pretty funny, Crow.
As the newly activated battle droid watches you do that and says, "Well done, companion. We must apprehend this criminal."
Bad man, this.
You're all a bunch of junk bucket of bolts. You're all a bunch of junk bucket of bolts, you know that.
I walk up and I hit him across.
Well, go on then, take me to...
I hit him on the back of the head. Say, what?
Ouch.
I just tank it because I'm tougher than this little punk asteroid who hit me.
Quiet, you.
I'll remember that.
You're coming with us.
Droid, I see. As I start walking with the cuffs on, is like, and all I'm thinking to myself, is I'm going to murder every single one of you.
Except your companions.
All right, and I think we should head to the palace.
All right, the droid takes point and begins marching consistently toward the sky ramp checkpoint. you reach the first checkpoint here, where there are just another group of B2s standing guard.
I'm gonna walk up and I'm gonna like whisper to the our droid and be like, "Let me do the talking."
Oh god.
It nods at you.
What's the clearance code to this sector?
He gives you the code. Sorry, I'm not gonna.
Perfect. All right, and I will march my little group to the checkpoint.
One of the B2s at the checkpoint goes, "Halt! What is your business?"
Signal activity. We found this bastard in the alley, mugging a baby, bringing him in.
Mugging a baby?
You all heard me. You all saw it. Awful. This one.
Oh my god.
I'm just thinking to myself, again, this is just me thinking to myself, all of you are fucking idiots. This is just in my own head. And I'm just trying not to hide the ultimate grimace right now.
And I'm just gonna hold out, I'm just gonna transmit the sector code. Taking him to the prisons.
Assault and robbery of an infant is a crime most heinous. Proceed.
Roger, roger.
Oh my god.
Jesus Christ.
This is awesome.
Again, in my own head, I'm thinking, you're all fucking idiots. This is, if we survive this, I'm going to scream this in every one of your faces.
Fair enough. I'll put a
tranquilizer. As you proceed past this checkpoint, you walk forward into the up the sky ramp, proceeding uninhibited. And you walk up into an open area where there is, in fact, a tank, an AAT tank parked right next to the, right next to a second laser gate, along with a full squad of B1s and B2s just standing there completely still, waiting.
How many can we count? How many can we count roughly in the two squads?
It looks like there's 16 of each.
So 32 total, got it.
32 droids and a tank.
Keep calm. And I'm gonna lead ourselves to the second gate.
And since you already got clearance from the first gate, this one opens up and lets you right in.
All right, as we walk past the gate, I'm gonna like kind of stiffly like stand and let everybody pass me. But as they pass me, I'm going to say to the lead droid, "Take this one to the prison cell, and I will take the rear."
All right, he leads you up a grand staircase. Well, across the immaculate lawn of the palace, just walks straight across it. And just completely trashing the grass with its stomping metal footsteps, going straight for the door. And leads you up a grand staircase into the magnificent entryway of the palace, where everything is blue and gold. There are beautiful pieces of art and magnificent pillars holding up the structure as they abruptly turns down a dingy staircase. And you are led down two floors. Of stairs, which is unusual in Star Wars. And you enter a long hallway full of cells. And there is a protocol droid sitting at a small computer terminal. And as he turns to you and says, "Got another one, eh? What's this one in for?"
Look into family estate. Harmed child. Harmed spouse.
Well, unlucky you. The protocol droid looks up for a second and pauses as you can see. It does a quick calculation in its head and goes, "All right, well, breaking and entering, assault and battery, robbery of an infant, you said." It pauses for another second.
Degenerate, and I'm going to elbow Drake in the liver.
Again, I just tank it because all of you.
The droid looks up at, looks Drakenstar right in the face and says, 12 years.
Minimum.
Put him in cell B13.
Copy that. And, as soon as they kind of turn, I'm going to lean in and I'm going to be like, "Need, how do I say this? I was instructed to gather information on one," checks notes, "Den Dip. Do you know his location?"
The droid goes into its data bank for a second and says, "Ramsey's Den Dip is currently incarcerated in the diplomat cell in cell C-17.
Thank you. And I will, like, put my hand straight out, and before I do
and
that,
as you as you turn away, the protocol droid says, "When you're finished, you should report to maintenance. I think there's something wrong with your vocabulator."
Before I don't turn away, what I'll do is I'll straighten out my hand, and I grab my lightsaber, and then I'll point it straight out, and I'll be like, "Thank you," and I'm just gonna ignite my blade, and I'm just gonna cut his head off.
Fucking sick.
Nice.
And then I'm going to catch up to the group.
Does he have to roll for that, or was that all in moment?
I'm going to allow that in the moment.
Okay, that, can I break free out of my, can I break my handcuffs then, if we're done with that?
Ooh, do you want to do a raw strength, an athletics check to see if you can break free with just your raw strength?
Yeah, I'll do that. That's 19.
after sitting here taking all of your abuse, Drakenstar pops the binders off as if they were made of string.
Crack! First thing I do, I look at all of you and be like, if we survive this, I'm murdering every single one of you. Droid wannabes. As I look particularly at Silas and Sar, Sar for hitting me in the head with his gun, and Sar for hitting me in the head with his rifle blaster, and Silas for nudging me in the ribs. We survive this. I'm murdering you both. There's your murder of crows there, Silas.
We got in, didn't we? I know right where Bendep is. Since cell C-17.
Well, let's go.
Let's go. And I follow after you guys.
As you proceed down the...
I'm still pissed, though.
As you proceed down the corridor into Section C, you see that these cells are a lot larger, and some of them very well furnished compared to the other cells that you've passed, which were very basic with just a sleeping platform and a refresher.
All right, I'm going to walk up to cell C-17.
As you approach the cell, you see inside an old man with a long gray beard and a balding head who is sitting at a rather elaborate desk reading a paper book.
Okay, I'm going to motion to Sar to hack into the keypad, open the door.
All right, I'm gonna walk up to the keypad and I want to hack into it. I want to try to disable the keypad to where the door automatically opens.
As you are doing that, one, roll a tech check for me. And Sir Crass, as stripping off his battle droid armor and throwing it to the ground, kneels before the door and says, "My king!" At which Dendup looks up from his book and says, "Dale?"
The door opens up. Well, sorry. Trev got a 25.
Oh, man. Yeah, you absolutely got it.
All right, the door opens up. Yeah, dude, he's stupid good at tech. I'm going to, stiffly walk in. I'm going to be like, "Ramsey's Dendep." I'm going to reach up and pull off my helmet. We're here to rescue you.
Rescue me?
I strip my armor.
Also, aren't you a bit short for a battle droid?
Nice. Yeah, we're here to rescue you. Trying to give you your place back on the throne. Throne. So my mouth broke there for a second.
Maybe you do need to get your vocabulary checked.
Sar.
As Dendup looks at you confused, "Who are you?"
Jedi Master.
I'm Jedi Master Silas Crow. These are my friends. You already know Master Crass.
I pull off my hood. I'm Jasmo Moden of Coruscant.
I completely strip and I say, "I am Jedi Master Sar Revan."
Apprentice.
Apprentice.
Ooh. You gonna take him calling himself a master in front of you?
It was a tongue slip.
I look at the boy sideways for a second. And I'm afraid we're running out of time. We need to get you out of here, Your Highness, because we're already on a bit of a deadline. The city is going to be...
You're a Jedi.
Come after soon enough, and we need to follow through with the plan. And we've already dismantled the prison droid up ahead, so we're on a bit of a time limit here.
I suppose we'd better take our leave then. How are we planning on getting out of here?
We are going to go to the platform deck above and get rid of an AT-AT tank, and I have a flare here that will signal another friend to come and pick us up on some Drexel.
You notice at this point that that Crass has fallen silent.
Motherfucker.
But as he stands there, begins to shake slightly.
His what the hand, hell's wrong with you, man?
His hand twitching as it slowly reaches for his blaster. As he looks at King Dendup, as his eyes glaze over, and he says, the true queen sends her regards and blasts him in the face.
I want to try and react. Can I react? Do I get a chance to react?
Sure. What do you want to try to do?
I'm going to try to just throw my hand up and try.
Athletics. See if I can either intercept the blast or catch his hand before he shoots the king.
All right. Roll it.
Unless that would be awesome.
What was that?
Wait, he rolled a natural 20?
11. No, I rolled in... no, but on my athletics, I got a total of 11.
As you reach out and grab his wrist just too late. As you rip the blaster from his hand right as the king drops dead.
What is the meaning of this?
I want to snap. I snap his arm. I break his arm right then and there for the bullshit he just pulled. Because he just basically ruined our mission. So my hand around his, I use my enhanced grip, my Toph grip, and I break his fucking wrist.
His arm snaps like a twig to your ridiculous strength as he screams and goes, ah,
and then I use my other hand. I put my hand around his mouth and lift him off the ground, holding him up by his mouth and throat. You fucking traitor. I should snap your fucking neck. I knew it. I fucking knew we couldn't trust scum like this. Every time we're betrayed. And you can just see I'm getting really enraged right now, almost crushing his jaw, but just enough that he's off the ground and unable to scream any louder, but I'm not breaking his jaw yet.
Brass, you better start talking.
I loosen up enough just to make sure he can start talking, but if I hear him start screaming, I start squeezing again. If I hear you start keep screaming about that little ting in your arm, I'll crush your jaw. Now talk, you fucking trash. You can just tell I'm getting enraged further and further.
Before he speaks, I go over to Master of Crow and I'm like, Crow, if he starts like speaking in riddles and whatnot, do you want me to shoot him?
How did I lose 4 tech?
Fuck shooting him, I'll snap his neck with my bare hands. This fucking traitor got us in here just to pull this shit. You better start talking now, Crassus. It might be the last thing you ever say. Now talk! As I just give him this intimidative look in his eyes as I'm holding him off the ground with one hand.
With your hand mushing his face, he says, what happened? What did you do? What's going on?
I bring it down closer to his, I release my grip on his jaw. I bring him towards the ground a little bit more, but keep my hand on his throat. Enough he's restrained, but enough he can still talk and breathe. Now talk plainly without screaming like a fucking child. What was this about?
He looks and sees the corpse of the king on the ground as you set him down, and a look of absolute terror comes over his face as he begins to weep. No, my king! What was this all for?
You tell Josh, us, bro. You shot him in the face before I snapped your arm.
Jasper kind of has his blaster trained on Crass as well. And he's like, yeah, start talking, bud. Otherwise, our buddy here is going to crush your throat.
Sam, I have no idea what you're talking about. I could never.
Bro, you said the queen sends her regards, and you shot him in the face. I just was short in stopping you. That break in your arm, right, snapped like a trying Marian toothpick, should be a reminder enough. Now you better make sense.
Wait a minute.
And I look over to Crow. What's wrong with his mind, Crow? As I stop myself.
I want to use Tremor Sense, and I want to see if there's anyone, like, around besides the prisoners.
Within 30 feet of you, there is only one other prisoner in a cell. The only tremor that you're getting feels to you like the light tapping of a foot.
I am going to run over to the king. And I just want to feel his pulse and see if he's alive.
He is not. He has a big hole in his forehead.
Okay. I am going to take a deep breath, and I'm going to glare at Crass. And I'm going to say, if you do this again, this will be you lying on the floor. And you see Silas.
And
his
I promise
eyes,
you'll die. It'll hurt.
Silas's eyes roll in the back of his head, and with both of his hands he like reaches across the length of body of the dead king, and I cast Revitalize. It's instantaneous, and I return a dead creature that I touch back to life, provided that it has been dead no longer than 10 minutes.
As you pour your force energy into the king's crippled form, you see slowly the hole in his skull begin to close and heal miraculously. And as the skull itself closes shut and but the flesh is still knitting itself back together. The king gasps back to life.
Easy.
I was like, Crow, I've never seen you do that before. As I look almost completely astonished. My grip's still strong on Crassus. I still look like, Crow, I've never seen that. You brought him from the edge of death. I didn't know you could do that.
Not often. You're
Jasper
alive.
Kind of like calls over. Oh, sorry.
You're good.
You first, Master Crow.
No, I'm good. You can see that just took a lot of energy from Silas.
Ah. Josmo kind
of
like
we need to get out
calls
of here.
Over to you, Master. I agree. And he kind of like motions his head slightly over to Crow and is like, Master Crow, do you think it's possible that someone might have been using the same power that you and the boy have, but of a darker nature.
To my feet, and I fucking walk a stomp over to Crass, and I just grab at his head with both, with my pinky and my thumb, squeezing on his fucking temples. And I'm going to cast Coerce Mind. And I'm going to reach deep into his mind. And I'm going to see if he has, like, a chip or something, some exterior piece of hardware or equipment that made him do that. Or I'm also looking to see if there's any of that same dark energy that I felt earlier back at the Merchant's Hotel. And I just want to see if maybe something that he was either influenced by something, or if he did this on his own volition. He needs to make a, I believe it's a wisdom save.
And I've got a 16.
All right, he fails.
As you reach into the depths of his mind, you do feel something. For a moment, a tiny wisp of reach in and feel for a moment another mind in his head. You reach out and touch it, and the moment that you make contact, it disappears.
All right, I'll release my grip. You're lucky, Cross. I was going to throw you in a cell if this was your doing, or if you had a chip implanted upon you, but this could have happened to any of us. It wasn't his fault. There's a dark energy around at this place, and it is very powerful, clearly.
I don't want him anywhere near the king, though, in case that comes to fruition again.
It wasn't his fault.
I pushed Crassus ahead of me. That's no excuse. If he was that weak of will, as I still hold him tight in my grip, to fall under that influence, as you find it hard for me not to lose my temper on him now. I don't trust him in case he gets taken over again. So you stay with me, Crassus. You and me will be in the front. The king stays in the middle with the others. And if I swear, I don't care if you're under somebody's control or not, if you try anything like that again, I will end you. Bring us all the way here. If you're weak of will, if you're too weak of will to stand with us and you put us at live, I will end you. Your other hand should be sufficient with this blaster. You try and point it at me, the others, or the king, I don't care if you're under somebody's control. I will finish you off. Do you understand me, Crassus?
He looks up at you, and you notice that he's stopped weeping. He looks up at you and says, with a slightly shaking voice, "Sir, I think you should. I've broken my oath to guard my king. Against my will or not, I failed, and I deserve nothing less."
Well, let's see if we can make use of what's left of your other hand to fire, be an ally out of here. But I will kill you if you would try, whether you're possessed or not. If you try anything like this again, I will end you. And be sure that none of them will
stop. I would thank you, sir.
Well, thank me if we get out of this now. We got the king. What's the plan? How many hours till the insurgent starts coming in from the Republic, Crow? As I release Crassus, but keep an eye on him and keep him on the other side of the rest of the way.
Too many than I'd like to admit, unfortunately.
I'm gonna say it's been about 2 hours doing the catching the droids, stripping them and sneaking in. So you've got about 8 hours until the cavalry arrives.
We need to lay low for the rest of the day. Do you have those
explosives still on you? What do you suggest? We stay hide down in these prison cells? Or is there some, like, a safety net we can hide in the castle beforehand? Crassus?
I'm afraid I don't know the patrols anymore. What with the droids?
What about you, Your Majesty? You've been here long enough. You've been down here long enough, Your Majesty. How often do other droids come down here?
As the hole in his forehead finishes, stitching itself up, he rolls his eyes at you and says, "Really, young man, I've seen so much from inside a cell."
But surely you would be able to know how often the droids come down here in the dungeon. It's kind of hard to miss their clicking, clocking, clickety-clocking buckets of bolts tripping down here. Could you have figured out anything? Any type of scheduling per the hour or hours? Or no?
I'm afraid the droids only come down here at meal times. You know, if you call what the slop they've been feeding me a meal. They come at meal times and when there's a new prisoner or when they need to drag me out to tell Sanjay that he's doing a good job.
Should we wait?
Your Majesty.
Go ahead.
What of the Queen?
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask.
What of the Queen? What happened just a few moments ago, whatever brought Crassus to fire upon you, he said the Queen sends her regards. Do you want to explain that to us so we have no more surprises to deal with?
He looks at you and says, "Queen, there's not been a queen on Onderon in over 100 years.
It seems with every answer we get two more questions.
Josmo kind of like thinks back to the very first mission that the group was on and is like, "Wait a minute, wasn't there a mission when we first started off together where we had to rescue some queens from Geonosis? What if they was brought here?"
You think a Geonosian queen could be able to control the mind of this king's guard long enough to control him to have him kill, try and assassinate the old king? Do you really think they're that intelligent to do so? Or that powerful?
And Jasmine's like, "Look, man, I've seen some weird stuff in this war. Anything's possible at this point."
Unless we're dealing with a queen from... What about... Are there any underworld queens? I spent a lot of time training over the years. The gangs, the bounty hunters, the hidden underworld over different planets. Is there an underworld queen trying to cause problems? Not royalty per se, but somebody who would call themselves that in order to control the illegal parts of the city before the droids and the usurper took over? Do you know anything of that, Your Majesty?
There is no major crime organization in Isis. And some of the Beast Rider tribes aren't the most civilized of people, but they would never try something like this, surely.
Let's keep that idea you brought up about the Geonosians.
My thoughts are, this isn't as simple as it seems. Why did you forego your seat?
It never bloody is.
On the throne to this Sanjay.
You want to tell me that you can have a B2 battle droid stick its blaster to your temple and say no?
Honestly, yes.
then you are a much braver or much more foolish than I, Master Crow.
He's so both.
Shut up. So you were coerced then?
I was forced to abdicate my throne, and as much as I was forced into this cell. The only good thing that's happened in the last 2 years is that they still give me access to the books in my library.
Well, it was Master Crass's...
Let's give you everything back.
It was Master Crass's wishes that we were to free you and put you back on the throne. How do you feel about this?
I would happily serve my people till my dying breath. Again.
Can you use a pistol? And I'll hand him the pistol that I picked up earlier.
I can't promise much. I've never been much of a fighter.
You stick with us, and we're going to go have a little chit-chat with Sanjay.
Josmo kind of like looks to Crow and is like a little suspicious, and he's like, Master Jedi, are you sure this is a good idea, having the king fighting alongside us when he just almost got assassinated?
What do you
propose?
He just
did get assassinated and then unassassinated.
What do you propose, Josmo? We need to leave him down here?
No, I'm not saying that. But then he kind of looks over to...
We can't trust Crassus to take him out alone, in case he gets possessed by the mind again. You're suggesting one of us... Crassus can't go with him alone, because then if he gets possessed by whatever forms took him over again, he will have not hesitate to kill the king yet again. The only other option is he comes with us, or... one of us separates to go with Crassus and the king to a safe spot. That's the only options we have.
I will go.
We can't just leave him down here.
Here's what I'm proposing. I will take the king and Crassus. If Crassus does anything, I will shoot him down.
I think weakening our numbers gives the enemy the advantage. Rule number 74. Should never split the party.
I was afraid he was going to say that. But at this point in time, Master Jedi, you're
worst
probably right.
Worst comes to worst, Stosmo. Worst comes to worst, if we're starting to get overwhelmed and there's risk of the king's death again, as I'm looking, again, getting irritated, we'll find a way for you and Crassus to get the hell out of here with them, and we'll buy you time to cover. The three of us are powerful enough to at least hold them off if we need to. But we need to figure out some place to hide or hide out, because we have 8 hours before the incursion begins.
Understood, Captain.
Your Highness, is there a king's chamber or something of the like?
I suppose Rash's private chambers would still be above the throne room if he hasn't completely destroyed my decorating.
Maybe going.
I noticed somebody else down in.
I'm focusing.
Kid, did you notice? Speaking of which. Sar, can you sense anybody in closing in on us? Is there anybody else down here?
You do not. Just the same tapping of one foot from a few cells over.
Nothing but a prisoner.
Which cell?
A few cells over.
To the right or
Josmo,
to the left?
Watch Crassus.
Got it. And I have my gun trained on him like a fucking hawk.
this is a bit anticlimactic, but would you guys mind if we wrapped up here? It's like 8:30 and I'm getting a bit of a headache.
Yeah, I agree.
I agree as well. I actually have a little bit of a migraine myself.
Good job, guys.
As
great
we finish
sesh.
Up, I just to end on the move. Yeah.
Go ahead. So
we'll just get back to me trying to see who the prisoner was when. Nothing. I'll say when we get back next week, I'll just go back to figuring out who the prisoner is, see if we can use them or lose them. But that'll be for next session. It was a great session, guys.